And we are live, finally. Took a little while. I'm a few minutes early, though, still. Which, you know, it's because I kind of sometimes can't wait the extra couple minutes. And I usually anticipate a couple hundred technical issues. Which usually leads to me being unable to. Oh, they have, okay, we can select video quality, I think, right now. Which is good, because I can't normally. Either way, we are doing some Afterbirth today to start things off. Wow? What's wow? So yeah, last time... I think last time we tried to do Blue Baby Alt Path? I can't remember. I still have greed mode I need to do as Maggie, Blue Baby, Eve, Samson, Lazarus, and Apollyon. Let's do an Apollyon greed mode. Or no, let's start with the daily, I think. Okay, so we are Eve with the Razor Blade, Curse of Unknown, Spider Butt. Already a tough decision, but since Razor Blade is unlimited use, I kind of want to go with Spider Butt for now. I can... I'm going to wait to see if a Spirit Heart shows up. A bomb would be nice because I could probably get both of those then. Oh god, we three-hit spiders. I keep forgetting how weak Eve is to start. You really need that Whore of Babylon to have anything going for you, really. Oh god, a mini monstro. Okay, we got a battery, which means we will drop Spider Butt on this. It will help us a whole lot. We're already at our boss. Grab the battery. Let's see what our boss is. At least it's only one of these guys. I don't actually remember how his attacks work, but they seem to be easier to dodge, I think. Other than the fact that he has rubber cement brimstone. Oh my god. Okay, we made it past that. We get an HP upgrade and a Spirit Heart / Red Heart. I want to see if I can get a Red Heart so we can turn that into a Spirit Heart. I don't think I'm going to be able to, though. I'm going to take the Razor Blade because we need Whore of Babylon now. We don't have a bomb or anything like that, so I guess the only other option is to check... Why are our tears red? We don't have any weight. There's no reason they should be red right now. Oh, perfect. Okay. So, pick up this, use this, activate Whore of Babylon, go down... So now we have two red hearts. Oh crap, I should have used it twice. Oopsies. Oh well. Now I can't use the Razor Blade without losing Devil Room chance, I'm pretty sure. The bomb is nice. Okay, if it doesn't affect the Devil Room chance, then I will totally just use it again. We got BBF. I don't think I... Actually, yeah, I don't know what I'll take it. It's gonna screw me, probably, but... It does stuff like that every now and then, which is really good. Okay... Well, this is a pretty good start, I'd say. all things considered, it's not, like, great, but it's not bad either. That's bad damage, though. Okay. Our boss fight is coming up. If I find a tinted rock, that would be nice. It would help out a whole lot, I think. We already got rid of the first four boss you can fight other than Ragman. But I think we'd actually do okay against Ragman right now. I do want to check for a tinted rock, which means I might want to go do the other rooms we have available. So I do want to try and secure this devil room chance, if possible. I don't see any tinted rocks, though, which kind of sucks. We can go check out the boss trap room now. It's a golden chest. I'm not going to risk it, because it probably won't be that good, all things considered. Okay, another key, and nothing of value. So we'll just go fight the boss. Maybe we'll get lucky and it'll be something easy. Maybe we won't. Okay, it's Monstro. So it's really easy then. Okay, Monstro's dead. We get a deal with the devil. We got Dad's lost coin? Wait, it's a range and luck up. Not really that good. I don't even remember what this thing is. I completely forgot that you show up. I'm just gonna take it. For the precedent. And no tinted rocks, so we'll go down. Caves 1. This is only to Mom, which is kind of sad, which means we really need to make it to Boss Rush. We need to make Boss Rush happen in order to do well on this. And we need to give away one more Red Heart, too, so that we can guarantee Horror Babylon State. I don't think that's worth it, even though it's not, like, bad. It's just not really worth it. Okay. I don't like this room. Don't even know how that pill dropped. Yeah, I don't even know what dropped that pill, so... Tears... Oh, Tears. That's great. That is a lovely... Tears ups are always nice. So now we know what that pill is. If we see any more, we probably want to go for it, because we need DPS upgrades. Because we're still sitting at base damage. Okay, there's our boss fight. Do I want to go? I don't think I want to go to it yet. I'm gonna go check out our item room first. I think... oh god, this is a lot of enemies. How the heck are you supposed to navigate that? Oh, there's another Tears Up, though. I hope. I'm pretty sure it's a Tears Up. Yep. Okay, that's good. Okay. Double key room, I will check out. We can reroll our run. I don't have anything all that remarkable, so I think it's worth it. We have marked a good rate of fire, decent damage, SMB superfan, Mom's Eye. This is interesting. Oh, and we still have the Horror Babylon? And we have the finger, too. And the little haunt. This is really weird. The finger points towards wherever we aim, but only if it's in one of the four directions. Which is kind of awful. Oh, bighorn. Perfect. This is weird. This is weird as hell. I have never used this item before. A few of these items I've never even touched, so. But I think he's dead, so that's good. I think we're gonna make it through just fine. I think he bugged there a bit at the end. Yeah, I guess we'll just go down. We may have screwed ourselves, because now I think we're stuck with a 0.75 times multiplier on damage. But we have other means to win here. We have a good fire rate. We have a really good fire rate. Even if our damage is base, we are pretty much at the tiers cap, which is really all you need to secure some kind of something at least. I need to remember to aim my mark instead of myself. What is increasing our damage? Oh, we have Deadeye marked. Oh, that's awful. That is absolutely awful. It means we're really good against, like, single targets. Or rooms, like, filled with enemies, but against anything else, we just pretty much immediately lose this bonus. Perks. Okay, so that'll be useful later, I guess. Deadeye is useful, except for the fact that we lose it pretty much at the end of every room. But against bosses, it may actually be useful. Okay. Daddy long legs. It gives us damage outside of our tiers, but I think we need better tiers. Creep shots, sure. I don't know what creep shots do, but... Oh boy, Mega Rag. This'll be absolute hell. Yeah, this is gonna be hell. Since we can't freaking... Oh, we made it. And we got old bandage, which is also not that great. Really nothing else to do on this floor either. Oh. Really? Why did I take it then? I should have re-rolled it again. Oh well. This daily is meh at best so far. But I think that's because I screwed up and instead of taking Daddy Longlegs, I took the shitty creep shots instead. At least we have the finger. Nope. Can't get hit, or else we lose our devil chance. Blackheart helps a ton. Okay. There we go. This is... okay, I wish we had a way to stop firing. Secret room is greed, goddammit. But he didn't get a shot off, and he gave us a steam sail, which is good. Means we can go to a shop, maybe get a... I don't know, something? That room is made easy because of that. This room, on the other hand, probably not so much. At the very least, we can make use of the finger. Which is really good, I find. I still think spending bombs on these is worth- God damn it, Marked! Stop shooting away my damn bombs! Okay. This is getting kind of ridiculous now, how every single room is these fuckers. I just want a room that isn't annoying as hell to complete. What did that? I don't know what did that. Thought we had enough speed to just walk through there, but I guess not. More of these guys. Is this gonna be this entire freaking floor? Come on. Almost done. I feel like I would have been better off with Eve's base damage. Wait, did I see a tinted rock just now? I must be hallucinating. Any tinted rocks here? Nope. How did we put out that finger. I almost said the pinger, which is not an item, as far as I know. Juicy sack is pretty good. Just leave. kill this guy because he's annoying. And pretty much we just wait until things get shrunk and then go after them. Sadly, that's our best course of action. We will check out the shop, though, because it'll probably have something good. Still not dead. There's still one guy left. Okay, let's check out the shop. We got deep pockets for 3 cents. Yes, please. A tears up, which doesn't matter, actually. I think I will spend 3 cents on the moon card. And then we, yeah, we need to get a deal with the devil here. We need to get something that'll change this run quickly. Fucking hell. Well, I think one of them got bugged. I think this fight got bugged. I am pretty sure this fight is bugged. But I don't care. Because it means that I will actually be able to win. We did it! We got a deal with the devil. We got Mr. Dolly, which doesn't help much. 2 black hearts. And in our devil room is multi-dimensional baby, which is just wacky, so I'm gonna take it. We can easily make our tears pass through multi-dimensional baby. With marked. I am forever grateful that that glitched, though. Double key room. 2 chests and a red chest. Nothing, really. But, you know, we got enough money that we can go to the shop if it shows up. Or if we have the key. Nope, not playing that. As long as we stand still, actually, we get doubled the shots. Which means I can just stand at the entrance and aim, and eventually everything will die. I mean, other than like against things that'll shoot at us, which is a lot of things at this point. Oh, we got golden bombs. Perfect. There's our shop. We will go in it. Hopefully it's not super greed. It is not. We get BOGO bombs. Another. This is our last shop too. So BOGO bombs. Our card is chariot, which is good. And there's no point in anything else. Glass cannon would be absolutely awful with this setup. Because I'm pretty sure it would just fire immediately. And there's Mom. I basically said goodbye to our chance of getting Boss Rush like 20 minutes ago. The moment we rerolled this run, I was like, yeah, I don't care about Boss Rush anymore. But I want to find my item room quick. I have to say, though, this is one of the weirdest runs I've had. And it's also uniquely awful, too. There's another key room here, which means this is a library? Which means we can get a book, which will be good. It'll help out. Even though I don't think there's much need left for, okay, what the hell is up with all these enemies suddenly? Library with Book of Sin, which we will use, gives us a key, and I'll take Book of Shadows. The heck? You can oh god, that's actually awful. The fact that you can shrink shot those tiny shots that these guys make. Okay, and our last item room has Lil Loki. Ghost Pepper. The body. Oh, homing. No! Homing! No! I accidentally dropped 1 cent in there and rerolled it into homing, and then the bomb rerolled it immediately after. Oh, okay. I guess we're gonna get stuck with Kane's other eye, then. Dejected sigh of disappointment. Because I screwed up everything. I screwed up a chance at making this run great, and we got Kane's other eye instead. Amazing. Yeah, this is uniquely awful, all things considered. Oh wow, we got hit there. Okay, come on, give me something, please. Give me a break, maybe? We're almost done, we just need a portal to open that is near where we're aiming. And we're done. Rank 2,777. Yeah, I feel pretty bad about that one. I feel like if we didn't reroll our whole run, we would have had something decent. But as we did, we rerolled. We didn't get a single damage up that entire run either. Closest thing was Daddy Longlegs, which I did reroll, and I ended up taking shitty creep shots instead. I rerolled homing accidentally and got Kane's other eye instead. So we could have done a lot better. Let's see what the global top is. How did you get 77,000? There must have been some kind of seam there. Either way, I think I'm gonna do an Apollyon Greed now. Range up is suckable. Speed and shot speed, I'm fine with that. Your range is already decent. Do we want any of these? Magic Scab might be good. Might be good enough. Mm. I'm going a bit too deep here, I think, but... Yeah. Now I need to go through this without getting hit. Come on. No! Yeah, we're dead. Bad start. I went a bit too deep. I need to take it. Speedball, it's okay. It's better than if we sucked it and got a speed and shot speed up. We have Curse of the Blind, which is actually awful. We do have a full heart here, though, so I'm gonna go in here again. We got a guppy item, I think. Guppy's head. We will suck it. So we are now 1/3 of the way to Guppy. I don't want to risk playing you, but I will buy the 7-cent item and the key. Other than that, I don't think I'm buying anything on this floor. Sadly. But what are we looking for? We want good spacebar items. I wouldn't mind getting something like, say, like Book of Shadows, Book of Revelations, Satanic Bible. If we could get both Book of Revelations and Satanic... Okay, this is kind of freaking ridiculous. You're still alive! Stop spawning bombs! How did I not die there? Fucking hell. That was awful. The waves we got were just portals, portals, bombs, portals, bombs. Suck it. Shot speed and range is awful. Absolutely nothing in here, and in our curse room, a chest we can't open. Oh, that's a nice wave to give us. It's a nice wave to start off greed mode. Three stone fatties that are just going to be chasing us for the entire thing. I think I'm hitting the button. I hate it, but I'm hitting the button. Because as much as I hate it, it is... I have enough money to at least buy a key and a heart at this point, so... And once we kill this, it'll get rid of these stone fatties, which will help a whole lot. Item room has cursed eye. No thanks. We will suck it. Once we get a reroll, we will suck it. But other than that, is there even anything we want from here? Jar of Flies does nothing. Spelunker's hat? No, because we don't get bombs. And Belly Button? No thanks. I could play the Judgment, but I don't think so. So we literally want nothing this floor. We want to suck Cursed Eye in the hopes of a damage up, or a tears up. But the rest, like... Oh, fuck off! How was I supposed to avoid that? You just spawned and immediately exploded in my face. portal, which spawned an enemy, of course, right on me. Don't die again, please. Okay. Suck cursed eye, which gave us a luck and speed, which is okay. Get another red heart. We do have a reroll machine, which I would use if I wasn't constantly taking awful damage. But I feel like there wasn't much I could have done in this case to avoid a lot of that. Because we just have nothing going for us right now. Like, we have not gotten a single useful stats up from Void. From two Void uses. We haven't gotten anything from our item room or our shop that has been considered, that can be considered good for our stats. So it's just trash, trash, trash. Oh crap. Please die. We are base damage, base DPS still. Which is not, you know, not horrible, but we haven't gotten a single item, because both of our item rooms have been crap. A flat range up, followed by a flat, like, a luck up, and speed. Speed is useful, but, like, everything else doesn't help much at all. I wish we had something. Something a bit more. And I feel like I can say that we are kind of getting shafted by the RNG a little. With enemies spawning right on top of us. Waves that are all, like, lots of portal waves. Okay, now we're through the tough part of famine, at least. Not tough, but this is the part that I have pretty much down to a, science. And he's dead. I need to do this without getting hit. Double Widow. We can do it. It's gonna be a little close, but I think we can do it. Yeah, no. One more try, and then I'm just gonna do an Isaac run. Placenta is takeable because it's regen. Chaos, yes please. And a golden chest. So we're gonna want to get 10 cents. Open up the item room. Another wave like this. So we're gonna be stuck with this stone fatty for the entire fucking floor, pretty much. Another four waves. Bombs, 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 bombs. More stone- fuck, Jesus Christ! Stop with the stone fatties! Oh my god, how are we avoiding damage here? I don't... I don't even know what to say right now. This is one of the worst, like, waves I've ever seen. One of the worst groupings of enemies. Stone fatties make killing anything pretty much impossible. combined with enemies that shoot at us, spiders, things that bounce around randomly, we are lucky to make it out alive. I have seen Greedier. It feels like normal greed mode is tougher than Greedier in some ways. I don't want to take that because I want Placenta to give me the HP. Flush. Sure. It's not good, but we will get chaos after this, though. After these bosses, a Widow, a Champion Widow at that. Which at least he doesn't spawn stuff, because spawning other stuff is what makes this hard. Pretty much. He spawns spiders, okay. He spawns lots of spiders. As long as we kill him soon, though, I feel okay. Good, we killed him just in time. And now we just have to deal with the Duke of Flies, which is not that bad. Other than the fact that there's going to be a lot of flies and some spiders at the top, which I'm going to want to go deal with quickly. Okay. I feel like sometimes it seems like the wave... I kind of just got bad luck when it comes to the waves, too. Because, like, normally you don't get, like, 7 stone fatties on the first floor that are constantly chasing you around. Also, you normally don't have base damage on a Greedier mode run at the start. I mean, you do, but you normally reset until you get some kind of stat up, because otherwise it's impossible. Or next to impossible. The two most annoying enemies to have show up in the newest expansion, making the mode that was considered really easy ridiculously hard because of it. This is ridiculous. You don't normally take 5 minutes for the first floor of Greedier mode. And I'm still not done. I can't damage him because I can't kill the flies he spawns fast enough. He's got like one more hit left. There we go. Oh! Yeah, like... We still have another wave we need to do, but I'm gonna buy Chaos. Actually, I'm gonna wait until after the deal with the devil to buy Chaos. Okay, an Envy and a Duke of... or a Husk. Okay, or no, that's another Duke of Flies. Deal with the Duke of Flies first. Because he spawns stuff. Placenta gave us some HP, which I immediately lost. Come on, please die soon. Duke. There we go. Okay. So we're gonna get a deal with the devil here. Hopefully it isn't Krampus. Envy on a large room like this is a breeze. Though I'm probably gonna have that come back to bite me in a moment. Okay. At least we aren't Eve. That's all I can say right now. If we were actually, if we were Eve, we'd have Horror Babylon, which would make this first floor a breeze in comparison. Okay, and our devil room has Gimpy, which I will take. And then we'll grab Chaos and we'll grab a key. No, we won't grab a key for the next floor. We will grab Chaos. And it gave us Monkey's Paw, which is actually good. And a pill, which is a range up, which is kind of useless, but whatever. Let's go down. So, we're going to get a key to start with. I will take this red heart. That's My Shadow, I think, which is not good. We'll get a key. Telepathy for Dummies and My Shadow, neither of which are very good. I will grab the half-price bomb and bomb both of these at some point. Item Room has Skinny Odd Mushroom, which I will take, even though it is a damage down, but it sets us right to the tiers cap right away. And a Guppy item. I'm fine with the damage down, because, you know, the massive tiers up offsets it pretty much entirely. Please continue to just spawn a single fly. You did, I love you. Oh my god. We need DPS. Like, we need more damage, pretty much. Which, I mean, fairly obvious. So we're sitting at 2.5 right now. I needed to take Skinny Odd Mushroom or we'd be at worse than base. Or no, we'd be at base damage, which is just horrendous at this point. And that's our last wave right there, which means we should be able to make it out of here without too much issue. I'm gonna save this pill for after, because it could always just be a telepills, in which case we'd have to redo like 3 or 4 waves. Okay. We're doing better, though. We have Gimpy, which pretty much guarantees our survival. $0.17 is not quite enough for me to feel good about buying something. Especially since what we have is, like, trash right now. We've got, like, My Shadow and Telepathy for Dummies. I'm gonna buy the 3-cent bomb. Bomb these guys. That is a really good payout. 2 more bombs. I need 1 cent. I will drop one here in the hopes of getting a nickel. We did. And I will use the other bomb for a reroll. That's a damage up. I am totally taking it. And then we want to get Mr. Dolly if we can, but I don't think we can. I can see forever. I will check for a secret room quick. $0.05. Okay, so we can get Mr. Dolly then. Actually, wait, no, it's not that good because we're at the tiers cap. Let's check out the curse room. Gimpy paid out with a spirit heart, so we broke even. And now we're doing it. We're pretty decent now, I think. We're a lot better off than we were last floor, to say the very least. Damage of 4, tears rate at the max. It's good enough. Oh god, Mega Rag, really? Deal with the summons first. The spiders. spiders are way more annoying than he is. I mean, we're in a big room, so it should be okay, all things considered. Got hit once, but it's not too bad, and he's dead. Thank God. Okay, and our deal with the devil fight is double Ragman. Thank God it's not something easy for some reason. Don't know why I said that. So many spiders. Good, one of them is dead. Two of them are dead. Okay. Devil room. Two tarot cards. So I guess we're getting Hanged Man and High Priestess. Did we have anything we could use the Hanged Man for? No. So I think I'm just going to take the High Priestess and use it in the next floor. Mr. Dolly or an HP upgrade? I don't think either of them are worth it, honestly. So I think we just go down. Oh, cool. Oh well, it's 1 cent. Not gonna make a huge difference, I think. Bob's Rotten Head is trash, but we can use it to try and find a secret room. I'm not even gonna suck it up. And that's Poison Tears. It's okay. And shop HP upgrade and Book of Shadows. I think I spend 3 cents here in the hopes of a reroll. Nope. 4 cents gets us more shitty items. But I will buy the half price key. Come in here. Two pills. Paralysis. Infested. Come out. Buy the 3 cent key or 3 cent heart. Okay, let's try something with this. Where our secret room can be there, which means I'm gonna try throwing Bob's Rotten Head right there. Didn't reveal it, but we do have a red heart now we can use. I should have thrown it here so I got money. Oh well. I think a secret room is a better play. No secret room there either, though I actually did suck it up, which means we can check every 6 rooms for a secret room, which is not that great, but whatever. I think we're doing okay now, for lack of a better word. Oh, okay. Yeah, we are doing just fine now. I feel like the first floors are always the hardest. Do not hit me again. Okay. We're done. Again. Another reroll machine, nothing worth buying. Infamy. I think Book of Sin is worth it because we can suck it. Epiphora is very much worth it. Gave us a 2 of clubs, which gives us 2 bombs. I think Epiphora is worth it, yeah. Gave us a key. Pays for itself, pretty much. Didn't get anything there. But now we have Epiphora, which is really useful, I find. Because it's going to put us all the way up to... Yeah, it'll put us down all the way to a tier delay of 2, which is great. I don't think we have enough luck to justify the insta-kill, so that's why I didn't take it. And I'll spend my last bomb on this. 3 more cents and a red heart. Totally fine with it. Yeah, drop a... Drop this here. Get up to a fire rate of 2, and then we just wait to see what spawns next. It is Mask of Infamy. Fuck. But our fire rate is kind of amazing right now. As long as I don't look the other way. Which shouldn't be too hard. The Mask of Infamy and all. I think we're gonna need to take on Mask of Infamy normally. Because he's just going to be too annoying to hit. I mean, if we get a single shot on him, if we poison him, it does a bit of damage. Decent amount. Not a ton. Mask of Infamy is just honestly annoying, to say the least. But I feel like they changed his AI recently. Made him a bit... easier to deal with, so he wasn't just constantly chasing you down. The poison also is gonna slowly whittle him, which will help. Not a ton, but whenever we poison, he takes about like a tenth of it, like a 15th of his HP. We just need to actually get the poison to land. Okay, a couple more hits. Okay, there we go. He is done for. We will wait for our fire rate to go up to 2. And then I'll step on this. It's an angel. Oh boy. He's dead. Thank God. And in our devil room is Torn Photo and 9 lives. I don't think Torn Photo does anything at this point, but I will take the second guppy item. Only costs us 1 HP. Yeah, I don't think Torn Photo does anything for us, so I'm not even gonna bother. Let's go down. We're at the womb with an okay run, but our only damage up is Steven. And there we're guppy now, so everything is okay. Everything has been forgiven. And King Baby, I don't know what King Baby does. So. Oh! Does he basically stop our familiars from moving? And there's Guppy's head, and Tammy's head, and a trapdoor. So I didn't need to take 9 lives, I guess. But, suppose it's worth coming in here at this point.
Feels like I'm walking on sunshine.
Paralysis.
Okay, so we broke even. Other than that, do I want either of these? Not really. I want to try and get cool void synergies. We don't have enough damage, I think, for Tammy's head to be good. We don't have enough damage for Guppy's head to be good because we are Guppy. I don't think it's worth sucking either of them. Book of Shadows. and Book of Belial. I don't think either of them are good enough. Actually, Book of Belial for the damage up might be worth it whenever we use Void. Let's wait for the fire rate a bit. Oh, we got Blood Clot. Damage and range. Perfect. Thank you, random luck. Guppy is making this also kind of a breeze. Had to hit that guy, sadly. Okay, and we are done with this floor? This room? I need HP at this point. I think that's my biggest problem. We will take Book of Belial. I will suck it up. We'll do that, and I guess we just have Book of Belial use now? I guess we do. Wait, did I hear a secret room opening? I could have swore I heard a secret room opening, but I guess not. Either way, we will, start off with the damage up from Book of Belial. And then double super MV is annoying, but we have actually a lot of damage now. Combined with a fire rate of 2, we are pretty much shredding everything. Okay, and our second boss is Loki? And what else? Oh, triple Loki? Wow. I didn't know you could get a triple Loki. But either way, we just destroyed him. Nine more cents. I think that gets us an HP upgrade, but I think at this point we want Spirit Hearts. Double Bloat is awful. Okay, so start charging. What the hell hit me there? Start firing down. Oh my god, don't kill me. There's just so much shit on the screen. They're the ones that spawn bombs too, which is the worst part. Okay, in our devil room, we got 2 black hearts. Thank God. Then, I don't think we want to buy the HP. Because it's too much at this point. I think we want to try and get Spirit Hearts or good items. Guppy's Paw is pretty much 3 Spirit Hearts. So I will buy it, and I'll just use it once. And we'll go down to the second to last floor, I guess. Right, I have the ability to fly. I should remember that. Item room has Anarchist Cookbook, which is not very good. Here we got Jesus Juice for more damage, which is good. Cricket's Head, yes, we need to buy Cricket's Head. Latchkey is too little, too late. Okay, so we're gonna buy Cricket's Head. Pretty much guaranteed. Empress, I think we're gonna save it for the Ultra Greed at this point. And yeah, I think we go Cricket's Head and then as many Spirit Hearts as we can afford. spawns on the fire. Yeah, we should easily, with this run, as long as I stop taking awful damage, we should easily be able to beat Ultra Greed. We probably wouldn't be able to do Greedier, but we could do Greed. Grab all this. Cricket's Head. Spirit Heart. And then just stock up on Spirit Hearts. We should be able to get two more this floor. And I think my bomb is going to go here for the chance of more. Didn't work out, but who cares. Did I want to suck up Anarchist Cookbook? I guess I might as well. We got another key. It's kind of useless at this point, but... Yeah, and the Widows are dead. We just need to kill the spiders they spawn. Like, this is overpowered now. It started out really weak, and now we're ridiculously strong. The only thing I need is, like, piercing. Piercing could make this even better. We aren't spawning flies anymore, which is weird. Okay, you should be dead. Yep, he's dead. Devil Room. Holy Mantle. And Book of Seek. I don't think we take Holy Mantle. As good as Holy Mantle is, I don't think it's the right call here. Because it would only prevent one hit. And we're giving up three spirit. We're assuming we're going to get hit three, like six times. For an item that'll prevent us from getting hit like three. For taking damage like three times. The miter. Don't think the miter is good enough. Some more spirit hearts drop, but nothing drops to begin with. I do want a bomb so I can bomb this. But we have a void charge that we could just throw at that anyway. So I think our right choice is reroll. And I need one more cent to reroll. Let's check this out. Another black heart. Perfect. Wish we stopped getting enemies that just ate up my my flies. Okay, we're gonna make it out of here completely fine. I'm taking a lot of bad damage though still. But I don't think it'll be an issue. We get a reroll. We get our void play on that black chest. I don't know what it's gonna give me, but I'm hoping it's something good. I think we just do the last two waves now. Another angel is dead. The stain is gonna be annoying with this attack, but maybe we'll kill him beforehand. Oh, it's double stain. Okay, double stain. Let's do our last devil room fight. It's gonna be double stain because it always is. Can't be paying out with the spirit hearts. Okay, what does our last devil room have? Probably nothing good enough. Satan- Too little, too late. One of the greatest items we could have sucked up showed up a little bit later than it could have. Sure. Battery. I should have used this for a reroll. Head of the Keeper. Penny Tears a bit later than we could have. So we have a battery here. Maybe Satanic Bible would have been the right play, because we could have just kept spamming Void and getting black hearts and rerolls and all sorts of stuff. Two of Diamonds.
Two of
pretty
diamonds.
Much exactly what I was hoping for. Let's reroll some more. Sacred Heart. And then a lot of Spirit Hearts. Yeah. So this is good. Our freaking shot speed is awful. Our range is horrible. Our damage is 21. Oh my god. This is beautiful. I should have saved money though. I think I'm gonna do this instead.
The Empress.
Head of the Keeper might actually be bad. I've realized. Please stop dropping hearts. Come on. I need to stop taking awful damage. It's kind of hard to actually, like... see all that well. My tears look exactly like his almost. But we're gonna win. Like, we're easily gonna win. Didn't expect to do amazingly, but we're gonna win. Bombs? Nope, hearts. He's dead. Brown nugget. We can donate up to 18 cents. Donate everything we can. I wish we had more. Wish we had more money to donate. We can't blow up anything, so I guess we're just gonna wrap up. Okay, let's do one more. So we got Apollyon Greed Mode. We have... we could do an Eden Mega Satan. So we have enough Eden tokens that I could do that. Kane Hush. Isaac needs to do the alt path. Let's do the Isaac alt path. Mm. No tinted rocks, but we can still get 2 cents for free, which is... Yeah, 2 cents and a red heart for free is pretty good, I'd say. And a luck up. Okay, that's an amazing room. And a tinted rock, so we're gonna use that at the end of the floor. Pretty much guarantee a devil room on the second floor. Yeah, you actually need to do greed mode twice. As a polyon. Because there's unlocks for greed mode and greedier mode, you just can't see the post-it note. It's kind of ridiculous, yeah. It's why I did greed mode first, to just so I wouldn't have to remember that. But yeah, this run, I'm hoping this is just nice and relaxing in comparison. The only part that's going to be hard is we have to make it to Hush, or we only have a chance of getting to the Void. I'm hoping that we don't actually have to go to Hush. Sister Maggie is not good enough. Dad's Key. There goes our Mega Satan chance. Unless I swap out the D6 for Dad's Key. No thanks. A bomb for 2 bombs. Yes, please. And some more poops. Maybe some more money. Maybe it'll give us something good. I'm not actually certain. We got one more to deal with before we can bomb this. Oh, we got a nickel. Okay, never mind. It's a bomb for a bomb and some poops. Still good. Still a fair trade, I think. Other than our time. It's worth it. Because the first floor shop could be really good. Come on. Come on, buddy. Okay, hey, what are you doing? Dancing circles around me. Little Horn is, you know, not that bad usually. As long as I stay proactive with bombing this and hope that that happens. Maybe hope that he walks into some fire. Speed things up even more. Yeah, he killed himself. He was the reason he died. He did more damage to himself than I did to him. I'm hoping we can get 2 more rooms. So we can get a reroll. But I will bomb that tinted rock on the way out anyway. Gluttony, you know, could be a Yum Heart, or not the Yum Heart, an HP upgrade. Could be worth it, but it'll probably just pay out with some red hearts. But if we get a Spirit Heart also, that'd be good. We got a chest with 2 more bombs. I'm fine with that. Okay. Secret room? I'm gonna check for a secret room, because if we can go to the shop on this floor, that'd be great. We can go to the shop anyway. Okay, if we can go to the shop without having to spend a key, that'd be great. We can. Restock half price, yes please. 2 bat- oh my god, thank you. I have to take one of them, sadly. Reroll Dad's Key, see what we get. Brother Bobby is just worse than Sister Maggie, so I'm gonna come back here, grab the other reroll. I don't think I'm gonna spend 5 cents on another reroll if we get something else that's bad. Seraphim is pretty good, I would say. Do we want to... Right, I need to bomb the Tinted Rock. Oh wait, no, it gave me a golden chest. Right. There's no Spirit Heart for sale in here, which sucks. So I think we don't get anything? And we're going down to the third floor with the second floor with 5 HP, which is pretty good. 5 HP, a decent amount of money. If we come across a shop, I'm going to it. Curse of Darkness sucks, though. There is a Tinted Rock here. I do have to spend my last bomb on it. And there's a Spirit Heart. Not worth using that Spirit Heart we just got for that. What enemies are here? Oh, just some pooters and spawners. Bad damage. Really shouldn't have taken that, but it's okay. We will keep moving. As long as I don't get hit one more time, our Devil Room chance is pretty much guaranteed. Because I don't usually get hit on bosses twice. More bombs. Shop has absolute trash again. But we got a nickel, which is fine. What pill is this? I found pills. What pill is this? Bad trip. Friends till the end. Okay. We're not buying pills anymore. Figured since we had restock and we had a lot of money, we could use some of them to figure out our rotation. I guess not. I think we want to go check for our item room first. Because as is, I'm kind of worried that we'll lose. We'll check for a secret room here too. Another nickel is always nice. I'm just kind of worried that we'll lose our Devil Room chance if we go in the boss like this. If we find another Tinted Rock, that would help out a ton. But it doesn't seem like we're going to. This should be our item room. Nope, a little bit more. Okay, is there a Tinted Rock here? No. Yeah, no, there isn't. Okay, so we're gonna have to take on this boss without getting hit, I think. Fate's Reward? I think it might be good enough. But I'm gonna reroll. What is this again? Metal plate? Damage? No, it's Spirit Heart, though. So I will take that, and I'll save my D6 for the Devil Room. Or if we want to take the Devil Room, I'll use it on the shop. Slow start, but as long as I make it to Hush within 30 minutes, we're fine. I don't think we have a need to rush yet. Ragman. As long as we keep killing your head, we don't have to deal with spiders. As long as we are even somewhat decent at dealing with your head, we don't have to deal with the spawns. Until you spawn them and heal yourself. Okay. So we would have lost our Devil Room if we hadn't taken this item. so I'm kind of grateful it showed up. HP upgrade. Devil room has a guppy item, so we'll take it. And I'll go spend my 2 rerolls on the shop. Welcome back. I could buy portable slot, and then we'd have a double reroll. Yeah, I think let's do that. Oh wait, no, because we can't actually buy the other item. So that was a bad move. We can do that, though. I didn't think that through properly. Second secret room is probably here. And we got a black heart. Oh wait, no, we can reroll this item, this shop one more time. The jar. Lovely. 3 spacebar items. And 3 rerolls. And we'll go down to the next floor. 3 red chests is worth it. We're still at base stats, which is concerning. But other than base stats, I feel like we're doing okay right now. We have a lot of HP, which pretty much means if we get a good devil room, we are set. Okay, you die, please. Okay, another battery charge. I'm gonna save it for now. Envy. This is gonna be fine. Shoop-de-whoop, we can reroll if it shows up, but I don't think it will. Oh, it did. Okay, so that'll be our reroll pedestal if we don't get our item room quickly. Or if our item room is okay. Okay. 2 more rooms and then we'll go back and drop 2 rerolls on that, I think, unless there's something. Unless it becomes something good. Double key room. I think I'm gonna do it. I think I'm gonna see what it is, because we have enough that I feel comfortable about still being able to go to our item room and stuff. It's a 3 room that rerolls all consumables on the ground, right? So it would reroll our battery, so I don't think I'm gonna do it yet, but I'll do it soon. Deal with this guy. And if we could get a bomb and bomb open that stone chest, that would also be great. Okay, come on, die. Okay, let's go back. Back here. Reroll. That was fail, even for my standards, yeah. Reroll Curse of the Tower, no thanks. I've been burned by it too many times. Guillotine, sure. Damage and tears up. And then I'll come back and reroll all the other stuff on the ground. Even though there isn't a ton. We got our bomb. This room became a penny, which is really bad. That room has trinkets and cards in it now, which I want to go back and check on this. A black heart for a black heart? Yeah, I think this is worth it. Black heart, death, and a penny for a bomb. That's fine. We can use it on a boss fight or some other room that's hard. Guillotine, I've never actually used before. I usually pass it up because it's really hard to maneuver with. But we are gonna make use of it because I'm feeling good today. You each spawned one enemy. That makes me feel even better. Okay. Just a card and yeah, nothing. I need to be a little bit faster though at this point, but we haven't gotten enough to justify going faster, I think. We need more damage and more tiers before I could even consider. I dislike Guillotine 2, I would normally not take it, but since we haven't had a stats up still, I kind of needed to. Sure, just do that. Walnut, I will take because it's, you know, some consumables. Sorry about that. We still haven't found our item room, which is really concerning. So I probably should have actually waited on Guillotine. Because we could have re-rolled it again. Can't open that yet. There's our item room, there's our shop. We're gonna go into both of them. Very much so, because we... Okay, sure, just kill everything. Piggy bank with the amount of damage I'm taking I think is worth it. But I want to check here first. Game Kid is our reroll. Guaranteed. Became Mongo Baby, which is, you know, sure. I'll take Mongo Baby. And I'll take Piggy Bank. Gives us 3 cents. And whenever we get hit, we'll get a penny now, I think. We do not have a good run right now still. This is not alt path worthy. Not even close right now. Dead end again. Really annoying to aim right now. So I didn't think there'd be this many rooms on this floor. If I had known, I probably would have re-rolled again, especially since the battery dropped. But as is, we will have a re-roll just in time for our boss room and our devil room. Oh, Tinted Rock in the card room? I missed it, but I don't have a bomb, so... Doesn't even matter. Yeah, we're... Fine. Devil room? No. Oh, it's an XL floor, that's why. Okay, I didn't even notice. So I'll save that for now. Our other boss is Chad. Which is, you know, probably where our reroll is going to be spent. I think Magic Mush would be lovely, but I think everyone says that. I think everyone agrees Magic Mush is lovely. Reroll it into a damage and shot speed, which I'm fine with, and we'll spend the other reroll on this. Since we didn't get a devil room, I will actually open that. Paid for itself. So I think we spend the reroll on the HP and get Magic Mush! That's exactly what I said would happen. Okay, so now we're good. We are good again. We are back in a place where I think we can try and make Hush happen. Otherwise, this is just going to go to the chest. You shouldn't have. Oh, holy mantle. Lovely. Speak of the devil. You didn't get a devil room, but he still thought of you. Yeah. What is this again? Pay to win. I don't remember what that does. So I think what I'm gonna do at this point is I think we go to the shop. I don't have a key. I don't have a bomb. So what I'm gonna do is... Actually, I can't. Reroll. I can't get anything here, despite my rerolls. Because we didn't get a bomb this floor. Okay, so I'll go back, grab a battery charge, and we'll head down. And now I kind of regret taking Guillotine. We have 10 minutes to make it through like 4 floors. I don't think that's gonna happen. This run became awesome, but it's still not that great actually. Magic Mush is our big stats up. And Holy Mantle is also nice. Can't go into the curse room yet. Another battery charge is nice. 3 red chests. And our devil room with... I can't take 9 lives right now. I can't. I have too much HP. It would put me 2/3 of the way to Guppy, but I just can't. Reroll. Sure. And 2 troll bombs. Perfect. Well, we know what we can get in our devil room, so I think I want to actually... Oh, we broke the walnut and didn't take damage. Okay. Faded Polaroid. Yeah, there goes our devil room chance, which is actually good. I don't want to get a devil room this floor. Oh, wait. We have Holy Mantle. What am I saying? That's why we didn't take damage. I want to not get a devil room so that our chance is higher on next floor. We didn't even take damage, but we got warped, so... God fucking damn it! These hands! We're not fast enough to... Well, we are fast enough to avoid them, but it's really hard to with, Sack, bomb and battery. There's our first bomb we've gotten in a while. Oh, it's just a headless horseman head and... Okay, item room? No, shop. I'm fine with this. Shop or library. If we do get a devil room, we can always just reroll again. Tarot cloth is good enough to take. Doubles the strength of our tarot cards. But I don't think double emperor is really... I think I'm just gonna use the emperor, though. Because we do have a devil room chance right now. And we do have a full battery charge. So if we did get a devil room, we could always just reroll it. We didn't, but we got pentagram, so I'm fine with that. heat this room. It's absolutely awful. I don't know how to do that room without taking damage. Still need to find our item room. There it is. Okay, hoping for something that negates the fact that we have guillotine. Lil Loki does not negate the fact that we have guillotine. That's not good enough. That thing's actually awful, so... Use the battery, come back here, reroll it again. Lard, no, we don't need more HP. I need a tears up at this point. That's the big thing I need. Oh, we got another battery. Harlequin baby. Not quite what I was hoping for. This is not a void worthy run. I could play this. Could do the sacrifice room shenanigans. Let's go for it. So I just need HP at this point. But worst case, I can just go buy red hearts from the shop. Because I think they're 3 cents, so... Oh, we got a 48-hour energy. Sure. I will totally take a 48-hour energy. Go spend it all on rerolls, unless this room kills me. It is sloth, so it probably won't. Two of clubs, doubled, gave us 16 bombs. Not gonna lie, I'm probably gonna die at this point. What, hitting this? We almost died just there. Conehead, chance of negating damage. I think we take it. Gave us the spirit heart. We'll just go down, I guess. Okay. Holy Mantle and Conehead, we have a very defensive run, to say the least. Even though it's not all that... It's pretty powerful, too. It's just not that great. Because of Guillotine, pretty much. Like I said, the fact that I took Guillotine is what makes this run so, iffy. I think. There's our item room. We have another battery for it. So I will totally... What do we have? Quad shot. Yes, please. Bad trip. We will save as a full health. I guess we save our rerolls for our devil room? We'll check out the shop. Half-price BOGO bombs is, you know, not really that great. So I'm just gonna bomb and reroll. Wooden nickel, not that great. Reroll, pay to play. Diplopia. I think I just want red hearts. Which we will immediately spend on this guy. Flatworm is better than what we have, so. Poison Touch, I will reroll. So we have a reroll target now. I can buy my red hearts back. Pretty much. Buy another spirit heart. I will come back here, grab the battery. And we will reroll the attack fly because it's not good enough. It became something even worse. Lost Cork. I think I like Flatworm. Do we have anything else we want to do on this floor? I guess not. I mean, since... You know what? Yeah, we want to do these rooms so we can reroll Monster Manuel. Red Heart is great. This room is, yeah, annoying, as I expected. But it won't be too bad. It's not hard because we one-shot the spider, the flies. Oh wait, no, those aren't bosses. I thought those were both husks, not just random enemies. We lost our Holy Mantle, but we got the reroll. This is a really simple run, pretty much. Quad shot, decent damage. Okay fire rate. Okay speed. Actually, we have pretty good damage, not just okay. Sure. Actually, yeah. This is amazing. I think we just got rid of the downside. We just got rid of the downside of Guillotine, swapped it out for another downside, and now we have Cursed Eye without any of the issues that come with Cursed Eye. Yeah, this is good. I like this. Bomb this. We are Guppy? No, two Guppy items. Gonna try and get a reroll, hopefully. Double justice is 2 cents, 2 bombs, 2 hearts. And our bad trip pill. I'm gonna play this. For the money, pretty much. We get Ivy Bag. Does Bad Trip not turn into full health? Okay, I could have swore Bad Trip turned into full health. Oh, the spirit hearts are beautiful. Puts us at the HP limit, 48-hour energy. I'm drowsy. Troll bombs. We want to take the 48-hour energy, obviously. I think we just use it to reroll this. Shrink shot, one more reroll. Rubber cement. How does rubber cement work with tractor beam? Weird. I like it. Do I want to reroll? Yeah, let's reroll this. Get in a friend zone. On our way up to the boss, let's stop by the shop, buy some red hearts, buy a battery, and then we can reroll our devil room if it's bad. But we only need one more guppy item. We've got the collar, we got the head. There is a battery here. I'm gonna just, yeah. Do this. I will bomb this too. The boomerang is not good enough. Car battery, double reroll isn't really doesn't really do anything. Placebo doesn't really do anything. 9 volt. I'll take the 9 volt. Okay. Now we go fight mom. Yeah, this is good. This is lovely. Polaroid. Devil Room has our last guppy item. I think I'm just gonna take both of these. Use this in the corner, check for it. Nope. Crawl space. Reroll, get another guppy item, and get goat head. Yeah, I'm fine with that. That is great. This run is amazing now. Go down. And if we get a void portal, I'm going to take it. I'm hoping we get it, because otherwise this is just a really good chest run. It's fine. It's a really good chest run with no chance of, no chance of us, getting a Mega Satan fight either. Because we lost our freaking, we got Dad's key on the first floor. Sure. Yeah, I think that was fine. We basically lost one key and got a bunch of consumables. And a trinket for no spacebar items. I think we want that. Oh wait, no, that's 404. That's not stop or no. 404 is just a random trinket effect, I think, which I don't want. Okay. Another battery, we can reroll our boss fight, we can reroll our devil room. Because our devil rooms are going to stay open, so we can reroll our devil room, which will be way better. God damn it! Really? There was the chance! The chance for like 6 rerolls in our devil room. Instead, we get a freaking teleporter down to the next floor. Oh well. Are two items better than tough love? Is the chance of a bunch of devil room items better than tough love? Hell yeah. But we're powerful enough that I don't think it matters anyway. Probably shouldn't have taken tough love because our luck is really low. But either way, this run is in the cards. Okay. Even if we get a void portal, I think we're just powerful enough that this will be a breeze. Sure, let's play you. HP upgrade I will take, and I'll play you. How does hookworm work with this? They're linear until they bounce, and then they just... Oh my god. Hey there! They're linear until they bounce, at which point they get zany. I like it. I like it a whole lot. Okay. Don't have Polaroid invincibility, so I can't play that. How do you even play this game like this? I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just pretty much holding down attack and everything dies. Demon Tail, no thanks. Even though it's good, it's not good enough, I think. It doesn't beat out the hilarity that is the weird hook shots right now. So let's go fight It Lives. We fought It Lives. We get a Devil Room with Dark Bum and Black Powder. Take Dark Bum. Reroll back Black Powder. Becomes Book of Sin. We will use Book of Sin. Get a bomb. Go out. Get a reroll. And come back in and reroll that. Then we'll go up to the cathedral. Usually you just die a bunch and wonder how people play the game and then cry. I mean, same sometimes. When I watch other people play, I'm like, how do you do this? But you just need to keep playing and you'll get better at it eventually. You'll get a good enough run at some point. I guess we aren't gonna get a reroll. Oh wait, no, there's a battery charge right here, but I'm gonna do this boss trap room quick in the hopes that... That was wasted. Do this boss trap room in the hopes that it drops a, Nah, crap, I could have played the Demon Judgment one more time. Or a bunch of times, actually. Bomb. So we will have to... God damn it! We have any more battery chargers? No. But we have an arcade, which I don't think is worth wasting my time on. So we will go reroll this item. Actually, I'll play you a little bit more. Oh wait, I can play you for free? Oh no, that was Conehead, I think, preventing the damage. I guess we'll take Missing Page too, and we'll reroll whatever's in our Devil Room. The mark. Yep. Lovely. We'll go up to the cathedral. Hello! How are you all doing today? This is a really easy run so far. It started off really annoying, and then I got Guppy, and then I got Hookshot, and then I got Quad Shot, and now it's just zany fun. Oh my god. The way the tears, they're just everywhere. So lovely. So beautiful. Honestly, I hope we get a void portal after Blue Baby. Isaac is gonna die very quickly. Yeah, he didn't even get it to fly. And we didn't get Fire Emblem Heroes. I haven't even played it yet. I haven't played a single Fire Emblem game. I should probably remedy that at some point. We got Bumbo, we got Spelunker's Hat, we got Glitter Bombs, and Pupil of Duplex. I don't think any of them are worth it. Reroll, take the pepper, because I don't remember what it does. I don't think the milk is good enough. Yeah, these guys just get completely decimated. Okay. Praying that... Where's Dark Bomb? Praying that Blue Baby gives us a Void Portal. It's a low chance, but if it pays out with that, that's great. Devil card is probably better than what we had. I don't even remember what we had. You're gonna go off? Okay, see you tomorrow. Let's take the hourglass to get it out. Reroll again. PhD. Is that worth it at this point? Thank you, Jujumatic, for the follow. Means a lot. I don't think any of these are worth it again. I want something that makes our run zanier, not like something objectively good. Because this is already an objectively good run. Black Bean. I'm not going to save a reroll for it. I'm not even going to take it, just in case we get one reroll and get like three amazing items. Okay. Two more rooms. This is just a lot of pills. Health up. Pheromones. Friends till the end. Amnesia. 48-hour energy. And X-Lax. Well, the 48-hour energy is great. When I do one more room, I'm gonna come back. Come back here, use the D6, then use the 48-hour energy, and we should probably get something pretty good from this all. I don't have every item unlocked. I don't even have close to every item unlocked. Ipecac. Fuck it. We hit walls and then our tears just go zany. But hey, quad shot Ipecac is pretty darn good. 48-hour energy. Dead Onion gives us piercing and spectral. I think spectral's not good with Ipecac. Undefined. Undefined in Demon Baby. Undefined can't give us unlimited error rooms. So it's not worth it. Yeah, I love this. Just when we hit a wall and our tears just go everywhere. Beautiful. What was up here? Oh, right. Devil card and a bunch of pills. Yeah, we are absurdly powerful now. Okay, two more rooms and then we can do another reroll. We can do another reroll now, so we'll go back again. All this backtracking is kind of annoying, but hey, if we get like something amazing, like something even more amazing. I wish I could fight Mega Satan. Dad's key showed up way too early. I will take both of these then. That was a dead end. Yeah, our tiers are weird as hell, and I love it. Oh my god. Okay, double adversary. We almost one-shot double adversary. Or, okay, one-shot the adversary, not double adversary. I want to fight Mega Satan, but short of getting, like, extremely lucky, I don't think it'll happen. I don't think Dad's Key can show up twice on the same run. And there's our boss fight. One more oh god. Oh god. Please tell me this works how I... Please tell me this works how I think it works. What? Oh no. Oh no, when our pepper tier fires, when our flame fires, our bombs immediately explode on us. Oh no. How does Loki's horns actually work? Yeah, it does. It is zany. And I love it. Blue Baby is dead. We did not get a Void Portal, so this run is over. That's 2 hours of Isaac at this point. I think I'm done with Isaac for now. That run was really good, but I wish we were a bit faster. We haven't done Hush as Isaac, so I should have went a lot faster. Yeah, there's a Void Portal. If you get lucky, or you do the Hush fight, which is one of the optional bosses, you get a portal that takes you down to a special floor with an extra boss. And I need to do that as this character to unlock some stuff. But that'll happen at some point. For now, I'm going to switch over real quick, and I will be back in a couple of minutes with Smart Tenelico.